Hello, I'm Delphine Parois, Director of Activities at Strategir. I am specialized in adult consumer issues in the food, hygiene, and health and beauty industry. But most recently, I have made my profile more digital by gaining new skills in managing long-term online communities. The objectives of this webinar is to demonstrate the value of digital approaches to better understand consumers of all ages. Why would we use digital methods? We have observed a genuine change in the way people are speaking about themselves and how people interact with brands. I think of the power of social networks. Why is this huge success? It's because social networks and digital interaction as a whole are fun and easy to use. For brands, this is a terrific way to be in touch with their consumers. This presentation is based on a case study from Mouton Cadet. The objectives behind this case study was to determine whether digital is a relevant approach to create insight for all generations. Indeed, the younger generation, that is those under 35, has specific communication habits and codes. For example, they do not use their phone for calls. They use email less and text and other forms of messaging more. They consider marketing requests unwelcome, are less easily convinced by brands, and so on. How can we engage when taking part in surveys? And for the brand owners, how to engage them with the brand? And what about the older age group? Do we need to use different modes of communication or not? Back to the case study, one was an interesting topic to use. It is a topic which is always a bit complex to speak about, and especially for younger people. A clear benefit for participants when using digital approaches is the sense of safety that being behind their computer or smartphone gives, so eliminating any fears of being judged on their views. Who are the millennials, the digital native? In fact, they grew up with the digital transformation, live with social network. They want to be heard, to give their opinion when they want, but they do not want to be questioned, which makes our job a bit complicated. They do not like to answer a structured questionnaire, which they see behind motivated by marketing, because they do not want to become marketing tools. Transparency and authenticity are key components to their communication, and thus waiting to communicate with them have to resonate with them in those respects. And what about the 35 and more years old age group? They are not digital native, but they have the same ability as the younger age group to communicate with digital tools. It is true that they have access to different digital communication modes through their professional environment. In addition, they are much more at ease with written communication than the millennials. In fact, they are multi-language. In terms of interview approach, objective was to escape from what we name the lab. That is a quantitative and structured questionnaire based on consumer claims. With this type of collection mode, participants answer from the first to the last question, answering all questions and respecting the order of the question decided by the research agency. The questionnaire is therefore exhaustive and the target is totally under control. We wanted to reach more connected targets using different media, but above all, we wanted participants to use a more collaborative mode, generating spontaneous feedback through healthy rivalry and competition. We also wanted to collect insights on the spot to view their real life and contextually their moment of consumption. In short, we wanted to get fresher insights. We did use the social networks for two reasons. One, to make the youngest generation engage and so react to our topic, and finally, to generate good insights for the brand. Secondly, to use multimodal sources of information like visual information with photo and videos, but also audio and text, putting the consumer at the center of the action. Participants collected that they experienced easily and instantly through clicks and snaps. To summarize, we moved away from a structured and controlled approach, like an online quant survey could be. We wanted to validate whether this freedom is answering would bring different elements, either new learnings or more sensitivity between age groups. So let's see what digital approach we set up. We set up a specific approach for Mouton Cadet. One, a mobile app to capture on-the-spot consumer behavior on a small number of participants. For the 60 participants we recruited, we wanted to be present at their moment of consumption of wine, in their intimacy. Indeed, the mobile app is simple to use and really friendly, relevant for all generations and social context. We gave consumers a task to complete. Consumers had to organize within the week a dinner or drink with their friends or family. They had to select and purchase a bottle of wine for the event, take a picture of the wine bottle on the table once it was set for the guests. They had several questions to answer relating to the purchase of the bottle of wine and its consumption. They had to film themselves doing a briefing, the group tasting, and also record an explanation of how their friends or relatives evaluated and appreciated or not the wine when consuming it. This kind of app gathers real-time contribution, downloads any contribution very easily, and also dialogues with participants, encouraging them to complete their task. Let's now move to the learning at two levels, across age generations and across the digital tool we use. The first main difference between age group is a difference in their readiness to generate written verbatims. For example, to a question like, what would you suggest to change the brand? Older age group was comfortable to share their thoughts and to generate many ideas, like a new label, a broader round, another drink, more feminine, etc. Whereas the younger age group didn't get a rich feedback, mentioning two ideas only. However, even if younger consumers are less inclined to express themselves in a spontaneous manner, they are very responsive to suggestion. As a conclusion, millennials will be strongly engaged if they are offered quick, simple, and fun ways to respond. One of the added value of a mobile app is to bring alive the different moments of truth, what we call the direct show. It enables the context of consumption of Mouton Cadet and its competitors with a simple and universal tool. Using the mobile is enjoyable and dynamic for all participants, younger or older. The main benefit is to truly reflect the consumer experience regarding the brand and its competitors. This brings the right perception and reality to the brand. When we ask participants to achieve a task, these participants will become the reporter of their own group or tribe. We ask participants to gather the evaluation and opinion of their relatives regarding the wine they tasted. This task allows us to get into the intimacy of each participant and to read the other persons. Initially, the task was done by 60 persons, but at the end, it is about nearly 200 feedbacks we gathered. This approach within the right task is an efficient opener to reach specific targets that are very difficult to reach, like, for example, fans of music stars, Harley Davidson bikers, etc. Thanks to the mobile app and its crossroad positioning, we can address many topics with friendliness and simplicity. The main objective is to capture a context. Context of consumption, of purchase, of visit, etc. It also enables to reach very specific targets and gather the opinions of the tribe each participant belongs to. It also validates within the intimacy of the participant any ideas. A last possible topic is witnessing the shopper journey. The mobile app is one tool among many other digital ones. In order to distinguish the main digital tools, we propose to position them on the first axis, whether the approach is structured or not. On this axis, ethnography is clearly on the left side, using a very open approach, as the concept of ethnography is to observe what is happening. On the opposite, An omnibus data collection is very structured in the way questions are expressed and the profile of the respondents being national representative. The second axis is the nature of the topics to analyze, some approaches being more adapted to social topics and the other to marketing one. On this mapping, the mobile app has a central position. First, structured in the way we ask questions and task to participants with a specific mission to do. Secondly, social, as we can reach a specific tribe and the habit in their intimacy. Open, participants can download pictures and video about their consumption. And marketing, with strong insight regarding purchase journey, habits, and consumption. To reach a world tribe of consumers and put a brand into context, more than ever, we need to engage respondents with the right tools at the right moment. It should be thanks to mobile app, as we saw in this presentation, but also thanks to online community in a more collective approach, either on app or desktop. Depending on the objective of the research, as you can see here, many solutions are possible. So thank you very much for your attention.